segue from these chromatic gestures, I'm going to go to another Weckmann piece now, lux Beata Trinitas. I will play the last verse from this gigantic chorale cycle. So Weckmann uses that idea of the chromatic inflections, and he takes it to a whole level within his contrapuntal design. This is a five-voice texture with the cantus firmus in the bass. And in fact, there's actually in the edition, the modern edition which you have, there's a mistake in measure 18 in the cantus firmus. It's clearly, if you follow the cantus firmus, which is, by the way, not the sarum chant version, but the version from the Melodien Gesangbuch, which was altered by Martin Luther. The melody was slightly altered. Weckmann does follow it to a T. He doesn't depart from it. The note should be measure 18. The note in the bass should be F and then D. That follows the cantus firmus, and that also fits the harmony. There are a few spots like that where I have updated it according to my research, according to my analysis, and according to the experience of having played this music a lot. So, yeah, I'm very excited to be able to share that in the new performance edition that will hopefully come out. And what I want to say about this piece is, again, the cantus firmus is so important because it's the structural generator for the piece. We hear much more modality in this. This is a very kind of foreign to our modern ears chant because it's in the hypomixolydian mode. So mode 8 is something that we're not quite used to hearing. It starts on a different note than it ends on. The chant starts on an A and the music ends on a G major chord. So in the beginning we might not know where we are, but we do find our way eventually. The text is very, very beautiful. There's this imagery in it that kind of speaks of sunset and sunrise at the same time. I'll recite just the first verse. O Trinity of blessed light, O unity of sovereign might, as now the fiery sun departs, shed thou thy beams within our hearts. So again, Weckmann uses the text for his improvisation. And, but again, you'll see that contrapuntal design here. It's not simply notes at random. In fact, this structure here very much reminds me of Bach's Piste d'Orgue, the Gravement section, that middle section with the suspensions. So even before that piece, we have Weckmann doing that idea. So it's very fascinating. So without further ado, O lux Beata Trinitas. The sixth verse in vollen Werck means with full division of the organ, so it's going to be a loud registration. There are different options that I explored for this, but I decided to go with that vollen Werck idea for now.